This is Spanish 1, Family and Community, Exam Prep, Sentences 9 through 12. All right, I'm going to read each of these sentences in English and then Spanish, and then I'm going to clap. And after I clap, I'd like you guys to repeat the Spanish sentence with me, okay? Here we go. Number 9. Ask your friend, does your brother play soccer? ¿Juega al fútbol tu hermano? ¿Juega al fútbol tu hermano? Number 10. Yes, my brother plays soccer. Sí, mi hermano juega al fútbol. Sí, mi hermano juega al fútbol. Number 11. What is your mother's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu mamá? ¿Cómo se llama tu mamá? And finally, number 12. My mother's name is Becky. Mi madre se llama Becky. Mi madre se llama Becky. Let's look at number 9. Now, in English we say, does your brother play soccer? But in Spanish we say, plays soccer your brother? Now remember, anytime you're asking a question, this is the word order for questions. Eat you tacos, drink you cola, kiss you on first date. So, plays your brother? Question. My brother plays. Answer. Calls your mom? Question. My mom calls. Answer. Okay? So, does your brother play soccer? Now, in English we say soccer. In Spanish they say football, which makes sense because if you've ever played soccer, you kick it with your foot. When you watch soccer, it's a game played with your foot. We call American football football, but we ought to call it pass ball or tackle ball because they really don't kick it that much, but I digress. All right. Notice, in English we say, he plays soccer, but in Spanish you say, he plays, and we stick in the word al football, okay? Now, here's the deal. In Spanish, anytime you're talking about playing a sport, you have to stick it in al. You don't say juego baseball, you say juego al baseball. You don't say jugamos tennis, jugamos al tennis. Now, how do you remember to stick an al after jugar in front of sports? Well, everybody listen and repeat. Al loves to play sports. Everybody. Al loves to play sports. All right, yes, my brother plays soccer. Now, we say, what is your mother's name? In Spanish, look at number 11. Literally, how herself she calls your mom. Literally, how does your mom call herself? Well, Mr. Holt, that seems so strange. I know, but that's just how they do it. Remember, how do you call yourself? I call myself Bob. How does he call himself? He calls himself Eric. So, ¿cómo se llama means what is someone's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu mamá? What's your mom's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu papá? What's your dad's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu amigo? What's your friend's name? All right? Now, finally, my mom's name is Becky. Mi mamá se llama Becky. Now, notice there's an accent mark here. This accent mark says, hey, don't stress the next to last vowel, stress me. If there were no accent, we'd say mama. But in Spanish, there's an accent mark, so it's mamá. ¿Cómo se llama tu mamá? Mi mamá se llama Becky. All right. This has been Spanish 1, Family and Community, Exam Prep, Sentences 9 through 12.